He's one of the most exciting fighters to watch in the UFC. Gone. No one wants a taste of his fury, and his name is Khamzaat Chimaev. Since entering the UFC in 2020, Khamzaat Chimaev has exuded a wave of dominance that befits a champion. He's had 7 fights so far, and with every fight, we get to see a different side of him. Now, before joining the UFC, and even while in the UFC, Khamzaat has been a Swedish wrestler. He's been active since 2015 and has never lost a match. But it's not just about his win streak, it's about his powerful takedown techniques in wrestling that got him to a perfect 24-0 record. Khamzaat performs some of the most wizardry techniques you'll ever get to see a pro fighter do. They're so unique, we can't even name them. He grips his opponents tight, forces them to back the wall of the octagon, and sends them to the ground. What do you call that fighting style? Exactly. It doesn't have a name, but it's a genius tactic. His grappling is very often compared to that of Khabib Nurmagomedov due to their similarity. One example is the handcuff lock and leg hooks. And you have to keep in mind that he's a freestyle wrestler, so he probably has thousands of other techniques we haven't seen him use in the octagon. Now, at some point, there was this narrative that fighters were afraid to face Khamzaat. And while it may have been true, we can only attribute that to his amazing knockouts and impressive highlights in the UFC. So let's go over them. Let's begin with his most dominant fight against Li Jinliang at UFC 267. We know Khamzaat has a breathing problem that started after he broke his nose at the age of 2. We also know that COVID-19 attacks the respiratory system. So when Khamzaat contracted the virus back in November 2020, things were hard for him. He was constantly getting medical care. But before this, he was slated to face Leon Edwards in the main event of UFC Fight Night 183, but couldn't because he contracted the virus. The effect of the virus on Khamzaat lasted for 9 months, and that was 9 months of him fighting for his life. But less than 2 months after recovery, he faced Li Jinliang at UFC 267. Now, Li Jinliang at the time had only 6 losses from 24 fights in his entire MMA career. For Jinliang, a man that can pull that off. His next major highlight was his fight against Gilbert Gudinho Burns. Now, this one left UFC fans with more questions than answers. Why? Because it was an absolute barn burner. At UFC 273, despite being acknowledged as the UFC's second-ranked welterweight, Burns posed the most formidable challenge yet for Chimaev. Despite widespread expectations that Chimaev would continue his streak of finishing opponents, the outcome diverged from this anticipation. Instead, Burns swiftly demonstrated his merit as a fighter, deserving of greater recognition, thwarting Chimaev's early takedown attempts and retaliating with powerful leg kicks and punches. While Chimaev intensified his attacks in the second and third rounds, landing significant strikes, Burns matched him blow for blow until the fight's conclusion. And don't forget the point in the second round, where Burns almost knocked the heck out of Chimaev until his coach scolded him during the break. I mean, if you're really looking for one of Khamzaat's greatest highlights, you have it right here. But ultimately, he secured a unanimous decision victory. Yet his inability to finish Burns surprised many spectators and compelled him to confront his errors in his next scheduled fight against Nate Diaz. However, things started going out of place when Khamzaat Chimaev failed to make weight at UFC 279, altering all the fights on the main card. Khamzaat was initially scheduled to face Nate Diaz in a welterweight fight, as we already said, but he somehow managed to miss weight by a whopping 7.5 pounds. It was clear this dude wasn't a welterweight, and besides, Khamzaat had fought twice at middleweight, making fans question if he was in the right division. But anyway, the pace was intense right from the beginning, with Chimaev wasting no time in initiating a takedown as soon as the fight commenced. Holland found himself in a frantic struggle to stay afloat. Despite putting up a valiant effort initially, Holland couldn't withstand the relentless pressure from Chimaev. Eventually, Chimaev secured a Darce choke, which, despite requiring a couple of attempts, eventually forced Holland to submit. This fight, if anything, was confirmation that the hype surrounding Khamzaat Chimaev was entirely justified, and we may well be looking at a future UFC champion. But to solidify that statement, he needed to defeat a former champion, Kamaru Usman. Chimaev wasted no time engaging Usman with his wrestling prowess, swiftly executing a takedown. Following a brief struggle, Chimaev maneuvered to Usman's back and delivered a series of punches that left the entire arena in shock. Burns attempted a choke, but Usman adeptly defended against it. But despite Usman's efforts, Chimaev persisted in seeking a submission while on Usman's back. Usman forcibly brought them both to the mat in an attempt to break free. Yet Chimaev maintained his position and landed additional strikes as the first round concluded. Early in the second round, Usman capitalized on a low kick opportunity and connected with the right hand, while Chimaev countered with a kick to the upper body. As the round progressed, Chimaev's aggression dwindled and Usman seized the moment with a combination of strikes, including a blocked high kick from Chimaev. But here's the thing, as the second round neared its end, Chimaev secured a takedown with less than a minute remaining, assuming side control as the round concluded and ultimately making the judges rethink who exactly won that round. It was a three-round fight, and when it came down to the wire, both men were in full form. In the third round, Chimaev initiated another takedown attempt to no avail, leading to an exchange of right hands between the two fighters. Usman's jabs found their mark, applying pressure with successive strikes against Chimaev. Subsequently, Chimaev reverted to his grappling strategy, securing another takedown. With roughly 20 seconds remaining in the fight, Usman managed to regain his footing. The final moment saw both fighters exchanging powerful strikes before the judges rendered their decision, ultimately awarding Chimaev the majority decision victory. It was a big win for him, no thought. And yes, we know, it's possible. If it was a five-round fight, Kamaru might have won. I mean, it's been years since he last fought a three-round fight, giving the reason he started off slow. And as we saw in the third round, Chimaev was already looking gassed out. He exhumed so much energy in the first round that many believe if that fight had gone two more rounds, or even one, Kamaru would have successfully put an end to Borz's streak. This win only served to grow the legend of Chimaev. At this point, the only thing to beat the Dagestani grappler is the scale. Borz was well on his way to a welterweight title shot, but missing weight has deterred him from that path. Nonetheless, Chimaev has found a new home at middleweight, and a win over Usman has shown that he can carry the weight well. Usman is now on a three-fight losing streak, with two losses to Leon Edwards, but he had five consecutive title defenses at welterweight leading to that point, so we don't think he should be bothered about the UFC cutting him off anytime soon. Also, keep in mind that Chimaev was supposed to fight Paulo Costa at UFC 294, but he withdrew from the fight due to an elbow injury, and Usman accepted the fight on 10 days' notice. With the win over the former champion now in hand, Khamzat Chimaev will likely get a chance to grab some UFC gold of his own. Dana White recently said as much in an interview on the Pat McAfee Show. He said, and I quote, "That is an absolute fact. The fact that these guys are taking this fight on short notice, the winner will get the next shot at the title, barring injuries and other things that can possibly happen." The middleweight division has been thrown into a state of flux recently with the upset loss of Israel Adesanya and Strickland's upset loss to Dricus du Plessis. The last style bender had been a dominant champion outside of a loss to Alex Pereira, but the tides have shifted twice now since his alleged retirement. So, will we see the return of the last style bender to claim the middleweight title for the third time? And in a match he has always wanted, a match he claims he manifested? Or will Dana White fulfill his promise by finally giving Khamzat Chimaev a title shot against the man from South Africa who had a meteoric rise in the UFC? Only time will answer these questions. Thanks for watching. This is MMA Warrior Clash. Once you're done liking and subscribing to our channel, kindly check out either video on your screen right now. Click on either video, and I'll see you there.